Hey, if you don't learn how to teach people how to treat you, you're going to be picked on and royally fucked with the rest of your life. So let's talk boundaries, how to set them, how to reinforce them. Let's get at it. Hi, I'm Pamela Lynn Serafin. I'm a trauma therapist specialized in neuropsychology, and I'm here to help you retrain your brain so you can recover from trauma and live the life you want and deserve. And yes, hell yes, that means you have to learn how to set boundaries. So I'm going to give you a four-step process. We are going to go through this in detail because you have got to reclaim your power. So today I want to go over what it takes and what you need to do exactly to teach people what you will and will not tolerate. And once you reclaim this power, your life will drastically change for the better, because toxic people thrive on manipulating other people. They thrive on emotional abuse, psychological abuse, behavioral, manipulative behavioral tactics designed to control you. Now, if you're in a relationship that's very abusive at this particular moment, that's dangerous, of course these tactics won't work because you're stuck under that, and that's their domain. So these tactics might not work in that situation. But for the regular adult that has now moved on from their toxic parents and are living out in the world, this is what you need to know and what you need to do. Let me rephrase that. I'm not just talking about toxic parents, although I do see a lot of that. Doesn't even matter your age. They could be 80 years old. You're still dealing with the same bullshit, stepping all over your boundaries because you don't have any. But also, it can be ex-wives, ex-husbands, children, colleagues, the list goes on and on. And they don't even have to be toxic people. If you don't have any boundaries, anybody will step all over you, because that's human nature, to get as much as they want, to push as much as they want. And if you don't have a way, a set in place plan to make sure that you put an end to it as soon as it begins, or you learn to call them out on it, like I said, it's a life you don't want it to continue. So let's go through the four step. Number one, you must identify your top 5 to 10 non-negotiable values. That way you'll know what not to abandon, drop, and compromise. Values are what guides your behaviors, and it helps you to understand what you will tolerate in yourself and with others, what you will and will not tolerate, I should say. So boundaries are extremely important, your values are extremely important. And I know that it's easy to just say, I have values. You don't actually know what they are, but you need to take the time to figure out what they are. And that reminds me, I'm going to actually create a PDF that with these steps for how to set your boundaries, and it's going to have a list of values. Go through them so you're just not making it up at the top of your head of like, I value love and wealth and yada yada yada. No, you need to think about it. And here's the thing, your values can change over time. The more you learn, the more you change, the more you grow, the more lessons you've learned along the way, the more failures changes your values. So this isn't something you just do once or twice or, you know, every 5-10 years. No, this is something you have to repeatedly look at so you know damn well what your values are. Because when somebody crosses your boundaries and it's linked to it, something you value very much, and they're crossing that, you're gonna know, you're gonna fight back. So that's number one. Number two, you must communicate firm boundaries. Now, if you're setting boundaries for the first time after you have let somebody walk all over you, you've got to prepare in advance. You have got to have very specific go-to phrases that you're going to use every time they try to push a boundary. So this might be something like, nope, that's not going to happen here. Nope, this isn't a conversation I'm going to have. Nope, this is not something I'm going to tolerate. It's that clear. I'm going to add on the PDF, like I said, about a list of phrases that you kind of go to phrases to make it a little easier for you. Because sometimes, like I said, you have to know in advance what you're going to say a lot of times, and you get really good at it. And I'm telling you, it's so rewarding when you can set boundaries and call people out on it that you're going to, there'll be time, you want them to cross your boundary because you're about to shut them down. And here's the thing, you never justify your boundaries. Don't explain them, and don't, your concern is to, or your responsibility is to yourself. Know what you want to say, but don't concern yourself with how they feel. That's not your concern. That's not your responsibility. You have a right to set firm boundaries. And it takes practice, yes, but I'm telling you, once you do it, you're gonna love it. And you'll be so surprised when they push back and you have that phrase in place like, no, that's not something I'm gonna tolerate. If you talk to me like that again, this conversation's over. It's that clear. That's what you have. Now, I want to add that for myself, I have gotten so good at setting boundaries that I'm really direct. So if somebody tries to cross a boundary with me, I actually say, you're crossing a boundary and that's not acceptable. It's that clear. And what happens, the more you set boundaries, the really how you are confident with setting them, you know who you are, you know what you tolerate, you know what you won't tolerate, then you seldom actually have to set the boundaries for people because they just don't cross them. And I find myself, I'm thinking, you know, I'm wondering if somebody's going to cross my boundaries because it seldom ever happens. So when they do, you're just, it's so fast. You're like, ah, no, crossing a boundary, step back. Is that firm depending on the situation? But you will learn to master it. It's so worth it. Number three, distance yourself. So here's the thing. Setting boundaries is about teaching people how to treat you. And what happens in toxic, abusive relationships, it's very hard for you to all of a sudden set them and be really good at it if you've had a history of not having them. Because this person who is usually overstepping your boundaries, they're so toxic and so manipulated and so good at bullying you that they'll just trample right over you. So you have to distance yourself in order to get enough strength to return to them and set up the boundary again. So this might look like, say it's a family member, because a lot of this is with family members. Families tend to think they can just do whatever they want, say whatever they want, get in your business, talk, you know, trash to you in horrible ways that they don't even speak to other people like that. But if they've raised you, or if it's a spouse that you've been dependent on or something like that, then it's, you're so entwined with this toxicness that you don't have any boundaries. They will just continue to step on you. So you need time away from them to gather your strength, gather your power, know what you're going to say, know how you're going to handle yourself, and then you come back into the situation if that's what's needed. So like I said, with family members, if you can't just, you know, cut them off the rest of your life, you have to somehow interact with these people. Then the idea is you meet, you're ready, you're prepared to set up that boundaries. When they cross it, then you tell them, that's not a conversation we're gonna have. This is something I won't tolerate, something like that. And now they're gonna push back, absolutely gonna push back. They might be like super condescending, like, ooh, boy, aren't you something, aren't you tough? Oh, you're so, you've got such strong boundaries, very condescending like that. Or they can get very mean and say, you know, who the fuck do you think you are talking to me like that? They're gonna like get like that. So your responsibility is to say, no, this conversation is over. And then you leave. And you have to be prepared to walk out and close that door again. It's not like you're not gonna ever come back if you have to. Like I said, if they're family members or you know, ex-husbands, ex-wives, whatever it is, you do have to, you might have to still involve yourself. But you get really good at teaching them. And they'll learn because they have habitual patterns now that they have learned how to trigger you, how to really get under your skin. But you're a different person. Once you set boundaries, you become a different person, much stronger, and they're gonna learn. Number four, interact on your terms. It has to be on your terms. If they're the toxic one, you are now putting yourself in the power position of it's on your terms. Yes, you'll interact with them, but they sure as hell better treat you properly. You sure as hell aren't gonna put up with their toxic behavior, their name calling, their condescending tone, their abusive behaviors. No, that's not who you are anymore. So you need to make sure, like I said before, you have your boundaries in place, you know who you are, you know what you stand for, and you interact on your terms. So when they cross the boundary, like I feel like I'm repeating myself, but it's worth repeating. When they cross the boundary, if they speak condescending to you, if they do some name calling, if they bully you, then you set up the boundaries. But really what's gonna happen, especially if you come back, they are gonna be so nice to you because that's how they manipulate you. That's the process. Usually bullies or toxic people, abusive people, don't just hit you over the head with it. They lure you back in. And that's okay, as long as you know that that's the pattern. You've got to know that that's part of the game they play, but you're ready. You're not the person you were before you let them walk all over you. No, not anymore. The moment they start to get a little toxic or you know where they're headed, say if they're talking about something as simple as, talking about your finances or something so how much money did you make or how much is he worth or something, it doesn't even matter. If you don't want to talk about it, if you're not comfortable with it, and you have to know that you're not comfortable, then you put up that boundary. That's not a conversation I'm going to have with you. If they try again, like I said, you say, no, it's not a conversation. This conversation is going to end and I'm going to leave if you bring it up again. That's what it is. That's boundaries. That's you taking back your power and saying, hell no, you are not going to fuck with me ever again. And I'm telling you, like I said, your life will change. You will never go back to not having boundaries once you master this. There's no way in hell that you would ever go back once you master it because it's so freaking empowering. Like I said, after a while, nobody actually even does it. So anyways, I will continue on here. Okay, in summary, the four-step process is know your non-negotiable values, communicate firm boundaries, distance yourself, and then interact on your own terms. You got this. I hope you found this video helpful, valuable. I'd love to hear from you. Please leave your comments below and don't forget to subscribe. I have a lot more to share. See you soon.